गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ वन. वेलकम टू बबीता कोचिंग क्लासेस. एंड टुडेज अवर फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज मैटर इन अवर सराउंडिंग्स ऑफ एनसीईआरटी ऑफ क्लास 9th. टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्लेन दिस चैप्टर मैटर्स इन अवर सराउंडिंग्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्लेन द मीनिंग ऑफ द मैटर इन अवर सराउंडिंग्स. दैट मैटर मीन्स एनीथिंग दैट कैन ऑक्यूपाई द स्पेस एंड विच हैज़ द मास. ओके. And here word is a given. Here word is a given surroundings. Surrounding means the near about the areas और आसपास की जो हमारी एरिया है उसके बारे में, मतलब जो भी चीज़ें हमारे आस पास हैं. टूडे वी आर स्टडी अबाउट दिस थिंग्स इन दिस चैप्टर. नाउ लेट स्टार्ट हियर. In the first paragraph, they want to explain that as we look at our surroundings, we see a large variety of things with the different shapes, sizes, and textures. Everything in this universe is made of the material which scientists have a name matter. In the first paragraph, they want to explain that means everything in the universe is made up of the material which scientists name it given the matter. And in the matter, like the food we eat, stones, clouds, stars, plants and animals, even a small drop of water, these all are the matter, or the even the particles of a sand also. Students, you can see that the particles of the sand is too small. But it can occupy the space. And it has the mass also. That's why it is comes under the matter. Then in the first paragraph, they explain only that what is the matter. Then in the very short, in the easy way, I would like to explain that matter is anything in our surroundings that can occupy the space and which has the mass. I hope you will understand the first paragraph. Now I will proceed to second paragraph. Now in the second paragraph, they want to explain since early times means before this times, human beings have been trying to understand their surroundings. Early Indian philosopher classified matters in the forms of 5 basic elements. That's name is a panch tatva, air, earth, fire, sky, and the water. According to them, everything living, not living, was made of this fire. Here NCRT is written, that's why it's some is missing from here. Basic elements. Ancient Greek philosophers had arrived at a similar classification. Means here they want to explain that in the early times, human beings in the early times, because people have no too much knowledge about that's why in the early times Indian philosopher classified the materials, and they have given the terms that is the panch tatva, that is the air, water, fire, sky and water. Now again they want to say that each and everything on the earth is a living or non-living thing. It comes under the matter. Now in the third paragraph, modern day scientists have evolved 2 types of classification of a matter based on the physical properties and the physical nature. Okay, it's true. Now the ancient time human beings have divided the matter into the 5 things, and they have given the word panch tatva. But now a modern day scientist has divided the matter on the basis of its physical properties and the physical nature. Then in this chapter, in the last paragraph, here it is explained that in this chapter we shall learn more about matter based on the physical properties, chemical aspects of matter. We will take them in the subsequent chapters. Now, first of all, students, I would like to explain what's the meaning of the physical properties and the chemical properties. Physical properties means outer look of the any matter. What its look. Suppose that if I will give you one pen, then if I will ask to you what is the physical properties of this pen, then in the very simple way we can say that the physical properties of pen is that it is a long, it is a blue in color, it has a cap, like that. Okay. Now Another thing is the chemical properties. Chemical means when the matter is goes under the reactions, when the matter is goes with any chemicals and it shows the reaction, that is called the chemical properties. Then in this paragraph, I hope you will understand better. Before starting this topic, next topic 1.1, that is the physical nature of a matter. Okay, I hope in this paragraph they want to explain only about the matter. Then we can I will repeat the definition of the matter. That is, a matter is anything that can occupy the space and which has the mass. And the students, only few words is a came here, that is a very important that in the early times human beings has given the words, that is a panchatattva, because panchatattva means here air, water, fire, sky and water. But you know better now times, or we can say in the modern time, matter is divided into the three: solid, liquid and gas. But in the class 9, two matters are also included here, that is a plasma and the condensate, both of condensate. Okay, then later on we will discuss each and everything. Now start the next topic, that is the 1.1, physical nature of matter. Now in this topic I will explain you what is the outer look of the matter, physical nature of matter. Now here this topic is a further also divided, that is a matter is a made of particles, that is that topic is a 1.1, it is a subtopic of a 1.1, physical nature of a matter. For a long time, two schools of thoughts prevailed regarding the nature of a matter. One school believed matter to be continuous like a block of wood, whereas the other thought that matter was made of the particles like a sand. Let us perform an activity to decide about the nature of matter. Is it continuous or particulate? Means in this experiment we can explain it, what is the matter. Now let us see here. Here is one activity is given, and it's a very interesting activities we can do in the home also, and I hope you will do also in your home, because each and every material is available in the home. And in the lab we can use the beaker, spoon, rod, glass rod. Okay, if it is not available in your home, then you can use the glass tumbler, spoon and the glass, and with the help of the spoon you can do it this experiment. Now let us start now this activity. In the first this is the activity, and in the science each activity is very important, because with the help of this activity we can understand any concept or the topic. Now this is called, if you will write in the practical copy this activity, then in the class time I told you that how you will write. The first of all, we will start from what is the aim. Okay, then after what is the materials required here, then after you will write what's the procedure, and last what is the conclusion. Okay, let's start now. Take a 100 ml of beaker, fill half the beaker with water and mark the level of a water. Dissolve some salt sugar with the help of a glass rod. Observe any change in water level. What do you think has happened to the salt? Where does it disappear? Does the level of water change? Now student, it's very very easy, and I would explain. Now in the home, beaker is not available, then you can take the glass, okay, glass tumbler, and fill the water, not fill the bottle till the brim. You can take the half water. Okay, suppose that you have taken the half water of a glass, and that glass you will add one spoon or two spoon of a salt in it. You can add the sugar also, it choice is your, but in this experiment they have added a half spoon of a salt. No, then with the help of the spoon, you can add this salt in the beaker, and the and then after stir with the glass rod. If you have a not glass rod, then you can use the spoon and mix it well. Then student, you can see that after doing this experiment, what happened with this one is the water level increases here. Is the changes occurs in the volume of the water? No, there is no changes occur here. No volume of the water is increases here. You know why? Because according to the properties of the water and according to the properties of the solid, liquid and gases, solid has, so in the solid all the particles are the tightly packed, no, tightly packed, and in the water some spaces are there, but in the gas lots of spaces are there in the particles of a matter. Same thing when you add the salt in this beaker, then what happened, the particles of a salt is occupying in the water spaces, the space which is already present in the liquid. Okay, so in this way the salt is adjust in this space and water is not increases. Then this experiment shows that if we add anything in the water, not anything, if we add water, salt, sugar, which can dissolve easily, okay, then the level of the particles is not increases. Okay, now here it is written, we will see the paragraph. To understand, answer this question, we need to use the tight dead matter is made up of the particles. What has it there in the spoon? Salt or sugar has not spread throughout water. This is listed here. The when we dissolve salt in water, the particles of salts get into the spaces between the particles of a matter. Now before start the new topic, new subdivision of the first topic, I would like to suggest something that you can read this topic nicely. Then after I will give you the second topic.